welcome to Istanbul, Turkey. It has arrived, the biggest weekend in European women's basketball. This is EuroLeague Women Final Four. First up to do battle are the reigning Spanish champions, Avenida, taking on the 2018 EuroLeague Women runners-up, Sopron. Both these teams have battled their way through a 14-game regular season. Tough quarter-final matchups just to make it this far. Is your lineup of semi-finals after our game with Praha taking on the home team Fenerbahce in our arena. The raucous crowd later this evening for that one. Both these teams though getting themselves set, neither of them entering expecting anything but to leave with the trophy. Here's the road to the final. Avenida beating Girona in a three-game stormer in the quarter-final while Sopron standing over at PLNA in just two games. Weekend of basketball ahead of us here in Istanbul. Likely to be four huge games. Two here today and then two on the Sunday. Avenida, well, they've been to the EuroLeague Women Final Fours four times. Progressed to the final in all but one of those appearances. And that record includes two wins over Sopron in the semi-finals in 2009 and most recently last season. I'm sure Avenida will take some serious confidence from the fact that they've been there, done that. They know how to get these semi-finals done. They're used to it. And they will be ready to go yet again.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
We're going to have player introductions here in the arena. Some of the fans have made their way.
First, I would like to introduce the players of the visiting team, Sopron Basket.
Well, as the visiting team will be introduced first.
And
they're familiar faces as a club to EuroLeague Women Final Fours. Fourth season in a row, they've been at the big show. However, they've only made it to the final once, and that was back in 2018 when they lost to Russian powerhouse Yekaterinburg. Many would consider them entering this weekend potentially as underdogs here within this Final Four, but I tell you now, as you see the roster being introduced, do not write them off. There is a ton of talent in those green jerseys, just ready to prove the haters wrong. Come back onto the floor. I'm sure the coaching staff have got them ready for this huge game, the biggest game of the season. Some of those players potentially the biggest game in their careers to date. And you think the pressure will pay, and that's part of the interesting thing we have here in the Final Four of psychology. Players revel in the pressure, look buckle underneath it. And for Avenida, come to the floor, and on paper, this is one of the rosters that is absolutely stacked. So much talent within this roster, it's unreal. Player to come out is obviously one of the highlight players. Voted MVP. She'll be picking up her award actually prior to today's game, but we'll keep reeling off talent after talent. Number 33 there, a welcome return to action for Peggy Lou Samuelson. Been missing for a while, and I'm sure the fans and Coach Iniguez will be grateful to have her suited back up and ready to go. We're going to have the presentations of some of the season awards as we see the presentation party come onto the floor, the trophies come onto the floor, and this is a great opportunity to celebrate the absolutely outstanding performances that we've had this season here in EuroLeague Women's. It's been a stellar season, an unbelievable season at times, and wonderful games across the continent, and superstars on show, and it's only right that we pay homage to those players and the coaching staff that have given us so much entertainment. party are now on the floor. Inéguez for Avenida picking up the Coach of the Year award, an 11-3 regular season record. Also on the storm that was the quarterfinals, they won a tough three-game series over Girona. 2 points for his players, saying it's down to you guys, it's down to my fellow coaches. Very humble man who has done a phenomenal job in Salamanca this year. With a very talented roster for Avenida, and now we're going to see the presentation of the big one for the players. Here's Coppa, Kamil Novak there, picking up the MVP for EuroLeague Women, the WNBA Finals MVP. Now she's the MVP for EuroLeague Women. Is there anything that superstar can't do? Who knows? She's also now going to be awarded her first team award as well. It's good to go home with some silverware. Many players don't focus in on the personal accolades, but when it's all said and done and you hang up those playing boots, sure that Kalia Coppa will look back at this season with very fond memories. She'll look back at those trophies and realise what an unbelievable season she's had. Averaged over 20 points a game, over 6 rebounds a game, shot 37% from down deep. She truly is one of the best players in the world right now. 3 minutes until we have tip-off. Here is our officiating crew for this evening. Yelena Tomic, Amino Manuel Akkad, and Mikhail Manis from Croatia, Italy and Estonia. It's an honour for officials, as it is for players, to be a part of the Final Fours. Officials are a strong setup. Here's your five to start for Chopron: Williams, Begvenet, Qatar, January, and Brooks. A strong five, that's for sure. Some real talent on show within that starting five. Williams, one of the highlight players. She'll be a big factor. Huge game last time out. 28 points and 7 rebounds against VNMA. Phenomenal performance from her. Your attention being focused on Kalia Coppa as we go to the starting five for Avenida now. The graphic is mistaken there. Seeing the Chopron team again on the graphic. I apologise for the mistake. What a team Avenida had alongside Coppa, who deservingly wins the MVP award. I'm sure, as I said, many of the fans are relieved to see Katie Lou Samuelson back from injury. She last played on the 1st of Feb in EuroLeague Women, and she really is a difficult matchup. Can step out, shoot the three ball, and work in the low post, causes other teams a lot of problems. Another player really to pick out for Avenida. Has to be their spiritual leader, Silvia Dominguez, a true leader this season. She had 36 points and 15 rebounds across the three-game series against Girona in the quarterfinals. And at times when the team looked, you know, down and out and really struggling, she absolutely stepped up to the plate, took the pressure on her shoulders and got the job done. Well, over a minute to go to the opening tip of the biggest game of the season for both of these teams. It's going to be an interesting battle of styles. Expect Avenida to try and make this an exceptionally high-tempo game. They want to get up and down the floor. They're offensively focused. Third highest-scoring team in EuroLeague Women this season, averaging 80 points a game. Chopron, on the other hand, well, they want to come to spoil that party. They're going to slow the game down. They're averaging under 67 points a game. So they need this to be a slower-paced game, a bit more of a war of attrition for Chopron. Avenida really are an offensive juggernaut, as we see Coach Gaspar, who's certainly in the running for the Coach of the Year honours as well. He's had a phenomenal season, that's for sure. Inéguez, let's say, picking up that Coach of the Year award, that raises expectations maybe a little bit more on his team. I'm sure no one had greater expectations than he does himself.
as we see the 5-4 Avenida come to the floor in the shape of Carly Samuelson, Dominguez, Rolas there, Coppers there, as is Hoff. The tough five to come to the floor for Avenida, plenty of talent coming off the bench as well. And smiles as well, and coach. Coaches will know how important the psychology of this is as well. Relaxed players usually play better. Most players do when they're relaxed. Moments away now from the opening tip. The biggest weekend of European women's basketball is about to get underway. Strap yourself in. Some of the best players in the world are about to put a show on for us. Attar wins the tip, but Copper steals away the possession. Pulls up for the mid two. No good. Rebound into the hands of Fegvenek. Attar now at the top, looking to feed the low post. Carly Samuelson being pinned down low, and that's a great play early on. Oh, Brooks. That's one of the problems that Avenida does have, slightly undersized, particularly as Katie Lou Samuelson has been out for a fair portion of the season. Hoff now inside. Oh, threads the eye of the needle. The pass from Copper. And Hoff quickly cancels out Chopron's opening basket. Ed Burnett looking to use the half-hour screen. Expect to see that combination a lot here today. Long drive to the basket and a rebound for Hathar. He gets the score, and she's been a dominant force inside this season yet again. 13.6 points, 8.5 rebounds again. A game for Bernadette Hathar. Fazola now looking to shake things up a little bit. Gets the space inside, kicks it out. Elbow jumper for Hoff, no good. Victory a little flat with that one. January drives the baseline, hands it into Hathar. Foul's going to get called on Hoff on the floor, though, so it'll be a baseline possession, I think, for Chopron. Nice pass inside from Graham January. She just whips it around the corner. Now long two, good defense by Hoff, enough to put her off, and Samuelson pulls down the rebound for Avenida. Minguez got the mismatch she wants. There's the pass inside. Why is Hoff not taking the shot? Poor decision making there from Hoff. Jumper no good. Hathar with another rebound. That's her second of the game already. Inside now to Williams. Looking to back Dominguez down. Has to fade away, but it's string music for the opening jumper from Gabby Williams. Who's voted on to the EuroLeague Women's second team this season. A strong season for sure. Dominguez fades away. Can only click the front of the iron though. And at the moment, Avenida's offense is not clicking. Williams inside, Hathar, another score, and Chopron are running away with things in the early going. Hathar up to 4 points alongside three rebounds. Copper inside, misses. Hoff with the offensive rebound, draws the foul, will head to the free throw line. And that's one of the bonuses for Avenida when you have a player of the sheer talent of Kalia Copper. You know, if offensively you're struggling, you can isolate for her and she will create her own offense. Off now at the line for free throws. Rattles home the first, only shooting 60% from the free throw line this season. The Dutch big. It's the second, and that will settle some nerves for her as well. I imagine but she'll make her way to the free throw line quite a few times here today. January uses the screen for Hattar. Elbow jumper is good. My goodness me. As Hattar started the game with fine form. Looked impressive all season, to be fair. Zorlan out, trying to blast past Fegvanek. Hoff drives inside, off the glass, no good. Sopron with another rebound, and their lead is at six with a little over three and a half minutes gone. January waits for the Hattar screen. Nice pick and roll, mid-range jumper. Not this time for Hattar, and Hoff is being forced to chase that shot out a little bit harder than maybe she wants to. Copper, crossover, draws the foul, hits the floor hard. Good sportsmanship from Bernadette Hattar, going over to check her opponent is all right. Yeah, there's the body contact. Aliyah Copper was built to do one thing, and that's score the basketball, as we see Fazula check into the game for the first time. Hoff heading to the bench. Copper hits the first of her two. First points of the game. 54% free throw shooter. First with that stat. Absolutely. That was inevitable. The Fons lead at five. 4 minutes played here in the first semi-final of the Final Fours this season's EuroLeague Women. Take the net. Inside to Hattar. Fazula's got the job to tie her up. Now travelling violation called on Hattar. Fazula, I think the way she looked at the official, potentially thought that a foul was coming her way. The defence did look a little aggressive. Let's have a look at the replay. Look at the, there you go. Absolutely great call by the official. It wasn't a pivot. It was almost like a second jump stop in there. Hopper now. Looks to go to the weak side. The defense is good by Williams, and that's why she does what she does. One of the leading defensive players here in EuroLeague Women. January, it's going to be on the floor. She was looking for the continuation, but the official said no. That's a foul on the floor. Dominguez called for the foul. With her first. Moment, Sopron are looking exceptionally confident. Sopron will make a change. Into the game comes Dolson, out of the game comes Hattar, and what a job she's done already. Big points for her so far. So that's a good move by Coach Gaspar. He knows he's going to need his big, his front line big for probably the entire 40 minutes if it doesn't even go to overtime as well. Williams, a little bit heavy with that one. That's good rotation by the coach, giving her an early rest, making sure keeping some of that energy and influence to the latter stages of the game. Hopper loses the pass. It's a poor pass from Fazula. It needed to be more angled towards the basket, as that's where Hopper was headed. There's the net. Come back out. Does so. Shot goes up. And it's good. Wow. What a shot. Elena Brooks nails the three. Didn't even see the net ripple on that one. Extends Sopron's lead out to eight. 4:46 left in the first quarter. It's Avenida 5, Sopron 13. And Coach Iniguez forced into an early timeout. His team are struggling on the offensive end. We're going to see if we
passionate,
can jump in.
Ambitious. Elite. Verbunden. United.
Inspiring.
Competitiva.
Ambiciosa.
Stylish.
Powerful.
Diverse.
Diferente.
Brava.
Inspiring.
See if we can listen into the coaches' huddle.
Yes.
what a start to the game for Shopron. A phenomenal performance, and you can see how pumped they are. Elena Brooks nailing the three. The big score, opening it up to an 8-point lead now. For taking over point guard responsibilities. Interesting to see what changes Coach Iniguez has made out of that timeout. Slight confusion, a lack of spacing from Avenida. Cazorla, long two, nails the two. Mighty Cazorla stepping up when she's needed. Danu now hands it off to Williams. Shake, trying to create some space. Nothing there so far. Azula's going to get called for the foul as he's working hard to stop Dalton from establishing herself low in the paint. A team foul of the quarter for Avenida. As we're going to see, Katie Lou Samuelson try to check back into the game. Can't get in for this possession, though. Move down low, Dalton against Fazula. Strong move. Fazula with tough defense. Dalton really did use her strength to get to the bucket. Copper now. Drives inside. Wide open, Samuelson for three. Not this time. She's looked good from the perimeter this season, Carly Samuelson, shooting 43%. That first attempt is off target. January now moves it out. Brooks. Oh, another three by Brooks. Elena Brooks, only shooting 28% this season, but decided to turn up and find a shooting form here when it matters most in the final four. Copper, oh, and the hesitation drop buys her the space to the bucket. Reduces Chopron's lead to seven. Begvinek, bullet pass inside, and Williams gets the score. Begvinek was just waiting, such patience from the Chopron captain. Baseline drive by Cazorla. Target with that, it was the right move, but the finish wasn't there. Williams now uses the screen well. January for three this time. Big rebound by Dalton. A mismatch against Copper. Certainly favourite for the offensive board there. Inside now. For Brooks. Brooks trying to fight a way to the basket. Samuelson playing some good defence. Been asked to play a lot bigger than a usual position, Carly Samuelson, this season. Been playing a lot of low post defence. We're going to see a double change here for Avenida, and maybe Lou Samuelson will step back onto a EuroLeague women's court for the first time since the 1st of Feb. So we'll see Rodriguez come out. Cazorla and Carly Samuelson head to the bench. Chopron will make a change as Jovanovic comes in for Williams. Rodriguez now feeds Cazorla in the low post. Cazorla looking to back down Dalton. Goes under the arm and scoops the shot in. Not the most textbook of shots from Fazula. But a bucket is a bucket. Begvinek now. Ivanovic inside to Dalton. Creeps it over the front of the iron and gets the score. And Chopron, the team, remember, that are averaging under 67 points a game, are on track to be scoring over 80 in this one. Really have come out of the gates firing on all cylinders. Katie Lou Samuelson now drives inside, kicks it out. Dominguez, the copper, corner three. That's way off target. Rebound pulled down by Jovanovic. Chopron looked like a well-oiled machine on the offensive end. That's going to be a travelling violation by Dalton, and you can understand why. A little shot faker pulled the defence out of place, created the space she needed, as we see Allery come into the game for the first time for Avenida. Fazula heads to the bench. Both teams rotating well through their rosters. Slip that pivot foot a little bit early. Oh, almost a tough move under the bucket by Dominguez. Couldn't get the score. Has earned herself a trip to the free throw line. And draws the foul from Vegvanek. Captain against captain. Dominguez scores the first of her two. I don't want to tell you her free throw percentage. I might curse her. Oh, go on then. It's 90%, so she is near automatic from the free throw line this season. Silvia Dominguez. Here's the second to drop as well. Cut Chopron's lead down to seven. She picks up her first points of the game. Ivanovic turns the corner. The defense rotates well. Shot clock at six. Vegvanek, long two. No good. Rebound pulled down by Katie Lou Samuelson. The copper now. Another hesitation. Dribble drives inside. That was always going to be tough. You feel that Kalia Copper is just forcing it slightly at the moment. She's trying to get herself jump-started into the game. She's only got 3 points so far. Remember, she's averaging over 22 a game. 6 second differential between shot clock and game clock. January passes it off, and that's a sweet stroke from Brooks. And Brooks really has been impressive in this first quarter. She's up to 10 points personal already. And the heave goes up and is no good. That's the end of the first quarter here in Istanbul. Semi-final one of EuroLeague Women Final Fours. 10 minutes down here. To be fair, it's slightly going against the form book. End of the first quarter. Job done alongside one of the most impressive centres in the modern game, Bernadette Hatar. She's had a strong first quarter as well. Of course, real problems for Avenida. Hatar, 6 points, three rebounds in 4.5 minutes of actions. As for Avenida, Hoff is their leading scorer with four. Another player has scored more than one field goal in that first quarter. Second quarter action underway here in Istanbul. This is semi-final one of EuroLeague Women's Final Four. End of the first quarter, Chopron lead by nine, and they extend that lead further with a real tough move to the bucket. Ivanovic gets her first score. And at the moment, it's hard to find a weak link in this Hungarian team. Rodriguez. Samuelson looks to fight away to the top against Dolson. Plenty of use of the footwork, but Dolson's defense is up to the match of Samuelson on that play. Ivanovic slow things down and come back up to the top to Williams. Williams now drives in off the glass. Good defense by Copper. Samuelson for three. Nails the three. That's exactly what Coach Iniguez and the Avenida fans will want to see. Katie Lou Samuelson back on the biggest stages, draining threes from the wing. It's going to be a turnover. Avenida will take possession under their own basket. January chalked up for that turnover as we see Hattar come back into the game. Dolson heading to the bench. Great shift from Stephanie Dolson. Late addition to the Chopron team, but she certainly has made a difference. Comes out of bounds. Pizzola is bodied off the baseline. Ivanovic playing some physical defense. January, screen again, stolen away by Samuelson though. One on one now with Brooks, drives inside. That's good defense by Brooks. Coppers there to clean it up though and get the score for Avenida. Chopron are going to call a timeout as their lead is down to just 6 points now. A strong start to the second quarter for Avenida. Has to start to the second quarter. But picking up some scraps to get a points tally up. Let's jump into the huddle.
To reduce that. Okay.
He looks relaxed. Brooks now. And back out to Jovanovic. Chopron continue to look very calm and composed on the offensive end. Inside to Hattar. Hattar, a little pivot. Good defense by Allery. I think for me, Allery might be one of the best matchups that Coach Iniguez can throw against Hattar. Similar style player, good wingspan, quite mobile as well. Allery now in the low post, shot clock at five, looks to drop inside. Hattar, once again, good defense by the Hungarian. Begvinek back onto the floor. Ivanovic, elbow jumper, no good. Rebound fight is going to be won by Copper. Second rebound of the game. 5 points for her already. Little crossover inside, off the glass, and gets the score. She's in full flow. Absolutely fluid offense. Look at the handle, the quick crossover. Slides down the lane for the easy bucket. Williams now to create space. Brooks, another three. Draws the foul. Going to get blown for on Katie Lou Samuelson. Yelena Brooks will head to the free throw line for three free throws. Look at the replay. Absolutely barrels into her. Coach Gaspar will be happy. Seeing Brooks head to the free throw line. Not the best of free throw shooters this season, just 63%. But the veteran has stepped up when she's been needed. The two quarterfinal games against BLMH, she had 26 points and 18 rebounds. Really does deal with pressure wonderfully, Yelena Brooks. It's the first two of her three free throws. Takes her tally up to 12 now. A clean sweep. All three from the line is good. Chopron's lead back out to 8. Hopper comes to the bench. Into the action, Silvio Dominguez. Interesting to take Copper out after she had that score in the last possession. Samuelson now going to drive inside, has to come back out. Still time on the shot clock. Rodriguez, long way downtown. A little heavy with it. Chopron grabbed the easy long rebound. Take the net now. Options in front of her, nothing there. Eventually it's put into the hands of Williams. Begvinek open for 3 and nails the 3. The veterans of Begvinek and Brooks just getting the job done right now for Chopron. Their lead is extended to a double digit, game high 10 points now. Rodriguez inside to Samuelson. Foul's going to be called on Jovanovic. It's a smart foul, really, by Jovanovic. Once she'd been sealed out by Katie Lou Samuelson, it was only going to end one way. And that's with Samuelson getting the score. She just needed to be careful not to get the unsportsmanlike, which she didn't. Slow-mo of the officials. That's the call. Very dramatic. Gazzola. Trying to use the screen for Mallory, drives the baseline, has to come out though. Rodriguez, no good. Rebound by Allery, smart rebound, doesn't get the score and ends up on the floor instead. Chopron with a player advantage right now, but Allery gets back in time. Hattar, shot goes up, no good, and she's certainly a lot colder since she's come out for a second spell than she was to start the game. Would attribute that maybe slightly to Avenida working out how to guard her a little bit better. Dominguez for 3, no good. And Avenida, one of the best three-point shooting teams in EuroLeague Women, shooting less than 17% so far here today. Under 5 minutes to play now in the second quarter. Begvinek to Williams. Williams, they're going to go to the baseline because Zola thought she was going to come back and use the screen by Hattar. Smart play by Williams, going away from the screen. Turns out it's just a short break for Leah Copper. She's back into the game as Zorla heads to the bench. Allery also heads to the bench. Hoff comes in for Avenida. Chopron will make a change as well as January comes in for Williams. Brooks gets the 2. 15 points already for Yelena Brooks. How determined is she to get the job done here today, take her team to the final? Foul's going to be called. I'm on Begvinek. Her second foul. Interested to see if Coach Gasper leaves her on the floor. 2 fouls this early into the game. The 7-year-old certainly knows how to play the game with fouls on the box score, though. Now been called here in the arena. We're going to jump into the huddles, listen to what the coaches have to say. calming timeout called there, really, from Coach Inagez. His team trail by 12. Could have been under so much pressure by Chopron. First 15 minutes of this game. Dominguez now. He finds some space. Has to come out. Samuelson for three. That one's short. Rebound battle won by Hattar. Her first fourth board of the game. Ducor now out to January. Long two. That one's good. And Chopron have just... The efficiency on their offensive end is absolutely unbelievable. Shooting 52% from the field right now, the Hungarian team. Carly Samuelson hands it off to Copper. Sets the screen. Off a little shake, drives inside. Go off the glass, no good. Hattar with another rebound. Copper's hit the floor and stayed down. Into Hattar, there's the score. The officials are going to stop the game as Copper's on the floor. I'm sure she took an elbow to the face or what happened. Still down. Putting a face of concerned players from both teams surrounding her. Have a look at the replay. Let's see what happened. She went up in amongst the trees. That one was off target. Oh, yeah, and there's the rebound. No malice in it at all. Just Bernadette Hattar bringing her arms down. Put the outlet pass away. She brings her elbow fully down into the eye of Leah Copper. Certainly going to shake you if nothing else. I think she might be looking for a contact lens. She gingerly sits up. I think the officials are going to go and review this one. I couldn't see it as an unsportsmanlike foul myself. As Copper's back on her feet. Appreciation shown from the fans. As an unsportsmanlike myself. Oh, just going for the rebound, bringing her arm down. Wasn't a thrown elbow or anything along those lines. You catch her pretty hard there. It's going to shake you up a little bit. Have made a decision. They're coming back onto the floor. They have given unsportsmanlike foul on Bernadette Hattar. I know what Coach Inagez is saying. He wants the other basket that Chopron just scored cancelled out. The foul was beforehand. Not going to happen. We see Rodriguez come onto the floor for Copper. She'll go and take the two unsportsmanlike foul free throws. 77% free throw shooters. Hattar will head to the bench. Just her first personal foul, though, so no real problems for Coach Gaspar and Chopron. It's the first of her two. Chopron's lead. Bring to 15. The second, make that 14. This is an impressive lead for Chopron, and I think the most impressive thing is that they've limited Avenida to just 22 points. 16 and a half minutes of action. I'm sure there's many teams that have achieved that this season. Avenida have been pretty impressive offensively throughout the season. Rodriguez now uses the Hoff screen. Back out to Samuelson. She'll put the three up. Nails the three. Carly Samuelson, and there's a fist punch to the bench. She knows what that means. Avenida to fight their way back into this game. The three-point game is going to be important. looking to isolate Samuelsson down low. The triple team comes across. Good defense by Rodriguez, but it will remain Chopra on ball. Brooks looks to bully Samuelsson in the low post. Shot is no good. Hoff grabs the rebound, almost has it knocked away, but Avenida hold on to possession. They trail by just 11 now with 3 minutes to play here in the first half. Dominguez to Samuelsson. She loses her footing and loses the possession. 2-on-1 break. Brooks has it stripped away. Foul's going to be called though on Dominguez. That will be her second foul of the game. Feet just give way underneath her. Brooks comes back the other way. Pazola called for the foul. It was on the trail. I think Dominguez actually got it clean. Joplin will make the change as Williams will come into the game. Avenida is going to bring Bellaro into the game as well. Avenida, it's Pazola that heads to the bench. Chopron, it's Vegvenek that will take a seat. Brooks misses the first of her two free throws. It's the second though. The provisional on the shooter, so back into the action. First taste of the action for Varga, 20-year-old. This game of her career, that's for sure. Rodriguez, good options in front of her, but the Chopron defense is working so efficiently right now. Rodriguez drives inside, draws the foul off Zucco. Much more patient offense from Avenida. It feels like they're happy for the game to come to them. They felt like they were forcing it a little bit earlier in the game. A little bit more patient, a bit more ball movement from them. Sets the screen, but it's going to be an offensive foul because Rodriguez went too soon. Her second personal foul of the game. Rodriguez puts her hand up and says, "That's on me. I didn't let you set the screen. I moved way too early." True, guards have to wait. Have to wait for your bigs to be set. Another really unnecessary error for Avenida. Traveling violation going to be called on Williams. Both teams making mistakes right now. Called by the officials. Rodriguez slides inside and gets the easy score. The lane just opened up for her. That trims Chopron's lead down to just 10 points. Rodriguez up to 4 personal. Timeout's going to be called by Coach Gaspar. And a resurgent Spanish team fighting their way back into this game. But still, the Hungarian team, Chopron, in the driver's seat right now here in Istanbul. Let's jump into the coach's huddle. Hear what they have to say in this timeout. Phase of the game for both of these teams now, really. We get close to the halfway stage of this semi-final. Chopron will want at least a double-digit lead to take into the locker room. Avenida will see that as the barrier. They can at least get within single digits. They will see that as a real comeback from them here in the first half. We're a big 2 minutes ahead of us now. Varga almost loses it as Carly Samuelsson is all over her. Williams drives inside against Hoff, gets the score off the glass, and that's just a hard nose, tough drive to the bucket by Williams. Dominguez has it stolen away once again. Williams out at the races with the easy score. No, she misses it. Not an easier chance. She gets a second bite at the apple, though, and gets the score this time. Williams with the easy miss, but still gets the score. She's up to 8 points personal now. Got 2 rebounds and 3 assists and a couple of steals to her name. Filling up the box score, Gabby Williams. Hoff now in the low post. To go to work on that move and creeps it over the front of the iron for the score. Her second field goal of the game. January for 3 in the corner. String music for Brian January. Her second bucket of the game. Certainly pulls a fair few strings for Shoprump. Nice backdoor cut, though, and a great pass as Velaro gets the score. Velaro, one of those role players, look for the limelight, just comes on and gets the job done when she's needed. 15 seconds left in the first half. 4 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Williams now. Puts the shake up, Velaro puts the three up and nails the three. That is a big score. Can Avenida get a shot away? They can't. That's going to be the end of the first half, is it? Or is that a foul call? Looks like there might be a foul call. Zucca on the floor in pain. See what the call is. I think Zucca is called for the foul. Yeah, absolutely, it's a blocking foul. I think that might send Rodriguez to the line for 2 shots. I'm going to review it to see if it was within the time. A good view to see if it was. Yeah, absolutely, it was. Pretty sure that was before we see the red light on the backboard in the distance. There's the contact. Literally just before. I want to go frame by frame, I imagine. Yeah, I think that's just before. There's the contact there. Oh, that's a tough one to call, to be fair. Let's see what the officials come out and say. It's either half time or we have some free throws to shoot. Nope, they're saying it was after. The foul was blown after. And that will be half time here in Istanbul. And my goodness me, what a first half of action we have had. It certainly has lived up to the billing. A wonderful 20 minutes of basketball. The half time score is Avenida 31, Sopron 47. That is a huge 20 minutes of basketball we've had. Going against the form book, Avenida certainly entered the game as favourites for this one. At the halfway stage, they trail by 16 points to the Hungarian team, Sopron. Here are some of the highlights from that first half of action. And plenty of highlights for us to watch, particularly from that player there, Yelena Brooks. She has scored an absolute ton. 16 points and 2 rebounds in the first half for her. Gabby Williams also in double digits for Sopron. 11 points, 3 assists, 2 rebounds and 3 steals already for Gabby Williams. As for Avenida, no player in double digits yet. They have 9 players on the scorebook so far for Avenida, though. Leah Copper with 7 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, and Hoff with 6 points and 2 rebounds are their standout players on that side of things after 20 minutes. But Avenida a little bit shell-shocked. This is a team that are averaging 80 points a game. They've been held to 31. And bear in mind, Sopron, they only score 67 points a game and they're already at 47. They could potentially have a 100-point game here today. A lot for Avenida's head coach and newly crowned coach of the year, Roberto Iniguez, to work with now in the halftime locker room. Avenida need to change things up. As for coach Gaspar at the other end of the floor, well, I'm pretty sure he's just going to be business as usual. Let's just replicate that first half performance in the second half. Joplin have been impressive on the offensive end, shooting 52% from the field, 71% from the three-point line. They are 5-7 from the three-point line in the first half, whereas at the other end of the floor, Avenida are just 2-9. Tough first half for the Spanish team. Things can only really get better for them. But Sopron really taking control of this game in an impressive way. Just going to see how Copper comes back from that injury. Taking an elbow from Attar. Closing stages of the first half, sent to the floor. Didn't look comfortable when she got back to her feet. Avenida will need to lean on their top scorer, EuroLeague Women's MVP, there to come back into this game. Sopron at the moment, leaning on their veterans, in particular Yelena Brooks, getting the job done, having some big scores all over the floor right now. Minutes of action ahead of us though. Remember, this is semi-final one here in the EuroLeague Women's Final Four in Istanbul. The second semi-final takes place later this evening on this floor as Praha take on Fenerbahce. We still have 20 minutes left in this one to decide who will be the first finalist, who will have their first opportunity. At the halfway stage here though in Istanbul, semi-final one, it's Avenida 31, Sopron 47. say the least. A 16-point lead for Sopron. I'm not sure many people had that one at the end of the first half, but Sopron have been impressive on both ends of the floor. Highly efficient on the offensive end, shooting the lights out and locking out one of the most potent offensive threats within EuroLeague Women. You have to give a hat tip to Coach Gaspar. He and his team have done a phenomenal job here in the first 20 minutes of action. Leading the way for Sopron is Yelena Brooks. She has 16 points and 2 rebounds. Gabby Williams also putting a shift in. She's on 11 points, 2 rebounds, 3 assists and 3 steals. But it really has been a team effort from Sopron. And it's for Avenida to change the direction of travel in this one. Coach Inegez, I'm sure, has been working hard in the halftime locker room, but they really need to change something up here, or Sopron will cruise their way into the EuroLeague Women's Final against either Fenerbahce or Praha on Sunday. Nina Brooks just been fine form today. Had an absolute standout season, the veteran, having just over 11 points and just shy of 6 rebounds a game. 16 points already today, 5 from 8 from the field, 2 from 3 from outside in particular. No real surprises. Sopron are back on the floor first. They were back out from the locker rooms first. Anita, plenty to talk over. Yeah, Copper's back on the floor as well. That will be a relief to the fans. Second half action underway here. The first semi-final EuroLeague Women Final Fours here in Istanbul. At the halfway stage, Sopron lead by 16 over Avenida. Plenty to do for the Spanish side here in the second half. Eddie Lou Samuelson inside, kicks it out. Wide open corner three for Carly Samuelson. That's her second triple of the game. Big shot for her and a big shot for Avenida. Williams now into direction inside to Hattar. He's fouled by Dominguez. Dominguez's second foul of the game. Smart foul really by Silvia Dominguez. It's a certain 2 points for Hattar if she'd let it go. Hattar will head to the line for 2 shots. The best free throw shooter, Bernadette Hattar. You can see a pull at that one. An awkward looking free throw style. There's the problem when you're a big. If you can't back it up from the free throw line, it becomes a bit difficult. She hits 1 from 2 though. It's her personal tally to 9. Off. Katie Lou Samuelson. Dominguez fades away. No good with the jumper, but Hoff will get the offensive rebound. Avenida will go again. Leah Copper now inside. No good with the jumper. With the layup. Forced it slightly. Williams now drives the baseline. Looks to go back. Come out for Brooks instead. Oh, and Brooks with a wonderful baseline spin. Leaves Carly Samuelson in her dust. Sopron's lead is back to 16. Sopron defense is so well placed at the moment. Dominguez inside, hands it off. Copper, easy 2. Leah Copper. He's up to 9 points now. Avenida need to work on the defensive end. They need to lock things out a little bit. Sopron have been free-flowing so far. January now, pick and roll with Hattar, and that's the problem they've got. That's going to come off the knee of Hattar and be an Avenida ball. Great defensive rotation by Samuelson. It almost looked like she may have fouled her. In fact, it's, yeah, it is going to be a, see, it's a shot from possession. The officials are having a bit of a discussion. Not sure who that's off. There's just a melee of hands. Officials are going to have a review, make sure they get the right call, and it's the right thing to do. It's a big game, and every possession is going to count in this one. The hand reaching in from Samuelson. It looked like it was off the hand of Samuelson, but you just can't tell at that angle. I'm sure there's going to be a better angle, though. And at the shot clock as well, 2.9, I would say, on the shot clock by the looks of it. It's going to be a shopper on ball on the baseline, 2.9 seconds left on the shot clock, 7.8 left on the game clock. Get the clocks back to where they need to be. Anita and slightly shell-shocked at the moment. Not sure this is the semi-final they were expecting. The semi-final they're getting. From still lead by 14. They've only got 2.9 seconds to create something, though. Attar. Mid-range two is fouled by Hoff. And we'll head to the free throw line. Third personal foul on Hoff as well.
Number 21, MSN.
So we'll head to the free throw line. She was one from two in her last trip. The first this time round. And the second. She's now in double digits. Shotgun's lead back to 16. As we see Hoff head to the bench and Fazula coming in her place. To be honest, Allery probably played the best against Qatar in that first half. I'm surprised Inegez hasn't brought Allery back in. Qatar's causing them the problems at the moment on the pick and roll. Dominguez now. Creates some space, nothing there. Nice pass inside. Fazula gets the score, and that's just a smart heads-up play between Dominguez and Fazula. Trading baskets isn't enough for Avenida. Chopin will be more than happy with it. Wing three is good. Brooks nails another triple. 21 points now for Yelena Brooks. Lula looks to put it inside to Copper. It will remain Avenida ball. Chopron have come back out. Much in the same vein as they played the first half. Selfless offense under the guidance of Coach Gaspar. Dominguez gets the score. Henry now brings it up over the half of Shopron. Being point lead for Shopron inside. Hattar can't get it this time as the defense is good from Fazula. And the ball is stolen away. Brooks will be called for the foul as Kai Samuelson looks to rip that one away. Look at the Dominguez cheeky score off the backside of January. That's a smart play. Saying, don't turn your back on me. Popping out. Screen just wasn't tight enough from Fazula there. Nice pass inside. Samuelson can't get it though, but will get the offensive rebound. Shotgun's defense just reset so quickly. He's ready to go again. Brooks will pick up the second foul. That's two in quick succession for Yelena Brooks. Second team foul of the quarter for Chopron as well. Easy one for the officials to call here. Just that little reach around foul. Inside to Copper. Double team drops on her pretty fast. Dominguez inside. That one's off target. Rebound falls into the hands of Chopron. Begvinnik now to Hattar. January for three. Off the rebound for Avenida. Puts it out in transition, but that one's too much sauce on that one from Copper to Katie Lou Samuelson. So that will be a turnover. And Avenida continue to struggle. Leading this quarter 9-8, but it's not going to be enough for the deficit they left themselves with. 16 points down at the half. He trimmed it by a point in the first 4.5 minutes of this third quarter. Pass inside. Hattar gets the score. What a pass, though, by Williams. That's where the headlines go. Williams with the assist. Henry going to be called for the foul as we see Cazorla come in for Dominguez for Avenida. Dominguez heading to the bench. The foul for January. Because they were smart in the first half, plenty of fouls to give. A real foul trouble for Chopron yet. Copper drives in, lane opens up, draws the foul. On Hattar. Her third foul, that could be problematic for Coach Gaspar. Jory will look to save. Yeah, easy call for the officials there as Hattar swipes the wrist. Dalton will come in the place of Hattar, and Dalton did a great job in that first half. And Hattar the break. Intensity in the paint didn't drop. The first of her two, and the pressure may be starting to play on her. She's just one from three from the free throw line today. That two from four now. Over 5 minutes to play in this third quarter, and Chopron continue to be exceptionally impressive on both ends of the floor. Williams drives inside. Fazula is going to get called for the foul. Williams will head to the free throw line. A call for the officials as Fazula just bodies Williams out of bounds. Smart play though by Gabby Williams. Good with the first of her two though, and maybe the pressure's mounting on both these teams. It's a huge game. For some it will be the biggest game in their careers. No matter whether you've been here the first time or the 100th time, the importance of the game will still have its toll on you as we see Williams miss both her free throws. Cazorla for three. Hits the three. Maika Cazorla. Steps up when she's needed. Foul's going to be called. That one on Cazorla. As January looks to drive through the lane. Avenida in the penalty now. Both teams in the penalty for final 4:35 of this third quarter. Avenida's reaction to Cazorla's three, the possession before. January at the line now for free throws as Begvinnik has gone to the bench and Jovanovic has come in for Chopron. Something to see in the background there. Leah Copper still slightly bothered by that injury she picked up in the first half where she took the elbow from Hattar, squinting a little bit and flexing her eye. Second free throw is no good. That will be have Anita Ball and Chopron. They've got to be careful. They can't get loose from the free throw line. They're 8 from 13 now. Zula in the low post, guarded by Dolson. Work, two bigs just down in the low post. Good defense by Dolson. Fazula can't get the score this time. January now sends it off to the corner. Good rotation by Avenida. Good team defense. Williams kicked it out. Dolson, mid-range two. After the iron spits that one away. To foul, it's going to be called. See who the call is on. It's going to be on Copper. Blocking foul. Oh, look at this one. It was off the ball. Easy call for the officials to make on that one. Copper just leaning on a player. Chop on with a 14-point lead. Pretty sure Avenida. Maybe not need, but certainly will want to have that back to single digits before the start of the fourth. Good hustle by Brooks. Pulls out for the three. Oh, that is back-to-back plays by Yelena Brooks that are huge for Chopron. She nails another three. She's up to 24 points, and she recovers what looked like a lost cause and turns it in. In fact, just the two. Turns it into a jumper from the corner. What a play. Copper now drives down the throat of the lane, gets the score. Copper up to 12 points. Ivanovic sends it off to Williams. Offensive foul is going to get called on Dolson, I think, as she pushes Copper in the screen. Let's have a look. Absolutely, she's still walking forwards. Easy call for the officials, that one. And it's 50 left here in the third quarter. 14-point lead for Chopron. Rodriguez, no good. Great rebound by Fazula. Oh, she walks away from it before it's gone down. She thought she'd scored. Didn't chase the offensive rebound. Doesn't get the score or the board. Dolson now scoops up the loose ball. And Avenida's defense has gone up a few gears, that's for sure. Ivanovic gets the score, makes them pay as their rotation falls apart in the closing stages of that shot clock. Strong play by the 31-year-old. Copper now. That's going to be called on Yelena Brooks. That's her third personal. Both her and Hattar on three fouls. Not overly worrying as yet, but could become. Fegmanek will come in for Williams. Also into the game will be Varga. I have a feeling she'll be coming in for Brooks. Harley Samuelson will head to the bench for Avenida. Oh, easy one for the officials to call as Brooks was just a half step late on the hedge. Copper continues to struggle from the free throw line. Remember, she was 84% going into the game. She's shot 40% so far, 2 from 5. The second of her two, though. Copper's lead is at 15, a little over 2 minutes left in the third quarter, and Coach Iniguez is not looking as comfortable as maybe he has for a lot of this season. Intercepted, good defense, and this is where Avenida's chance comes, is the fact that they've increased the intensity on the defensive end. Ball passed though by Rodriguez, and that one's stolen away by Chopron. Can't afford to make those mistakes if they want to get back into this, because Chopron been very, very strong defensively this game. Beg Burnett. Pass inside to Dolson. Gets the score, and that's just patience by Beg Burnett. Waited for the Avenida defense to open up in a way that could free Dolson up. Dolson gets the score. Their second bucket of the game. Offensive foul is going to be called. Samuelson called for the offensive foul. The wheels are starting to fall off the Avenida bus. Trail by 17. 1 minute and 19 left in the third quarter. This is going to be a Herculean effort. As we see Allery come back into the game for Fazula. The Pirates coach in against hasn't used Allery more. It's pretty good in the first half. Again, Tatar, Varga, jumper's no good. Rebound by Rodriguez. Cazorla, smart move by Cazorla. Gets the score. 15-point lead for Sopron. 45 seconds in the third to play. Every possession will count now for both of these teams as Sopron look to keep Avenida at arm's length. Avenida look to fight their way back into this. Oh, what a pass by Dolson. Varga couldn't take hold of it, though. And the three is no good for January. Second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Fazula uses the screen from Samuelson. Doesn't take the three. She'll take the two, and she'll nail it. A potential three-point play for Katie Lou Samuelson. Ice cold. That's a tough shot as well. Faked the three, stepped in, drew the foul, and nailed the jumper. Rattles home the bonus from the free throw line. 11 seconds remaining for Sopron to work with, and Sopron's lead has been trimmed down to just 12 points now. Avenida have outscored them by four in this quarter. Begvinek hands it back to Williams. Almost stolen away by Kopp. I'm not sure if they're going to get a shot away. They do. They won't get the score, though. The foul has been called on Copper. On the buzzer beater three from Williams. Let's see what the officials say. I think they're sending Williams to the line for three free throws. If that's the case, then Copper has given Sopron the biggest get out of jail free card you've ever seen. They're going to review it to see again, I presume, the clock. Get the shot away. Was the foul in time? Yeah, absolutely was in time. Not sure why Copper is challenging that shot so hard. The prayer from a tough angle from distance. That is going to see Williams go to the free throw line for three free throws. He was a 74% free throw shooter prior to today's game. 4-2 from the free throw line so far, though. 11 points, 6 assists and 3 rebounds. Officials, I think, are just looking to see what time is on the clock. It's going to be 0.5 or 0.6 of a second, maybe. The official goes to the timekeeper. Going to be 0.5 of a second to be placed onto the third quarter clock. So Avenida will have 0.5 of a second to work with if Williams hits the final of her three free throws.
Three shots.
Which then Sopron's lead back up to 15, and that really would be a heartbreaker for Avenida. They've worked so hard to bring it down to 12. Williams misses the first of her three. Apology doesn't look good from the free throw line for her. Look comfortable or confident. This is the second. And this is where pressure tells. The big players step up. Players crumble at times. Williams misses all three. They're not going to get a shot away, but I think Avenida will take that one. 0 from 3 from the free throw line to close out the third quarter. Unbelievable. The end of the third quarter, Avenida 52, Chopron 64. Tough third quarter as Avenida looked to battle their way back into that one. They outscored Chopron by 4-21-17 in favour of Avenida in that quarter. But is it enough? They still trail by 12. We have one quarter of action left. We feel that Avenida are going to need to be near perfect on both ends of the floor if they're going to make it through to back-to-back EuroLeague Women's Finals. As for Chopron, wow, these are things dreams are made of. Can they make it through to a final here? They were underdogs entering the game, but they have looked very impressive throughout. They won the first quarter by 9, the second quarter by 7. That's what put them in such a powerful position. Can they make it back to the final? They've been there since 2018, when they lost to Yekaterinburg. Here are some of the highlights from that third quarter. Avenida did look better, but still didn't look at their usual fluid self. A little bit rattled, a bit shaky at the moment. But down to Chopron now. So Gaspar, I think, has managed his rotation well. He's going to have some fresh legs and some fouls to give in the final quarter. Truly is, as we see a replay of that cheeky play by Dominguez. Literally, the cheeky play. Fourth quarter action underway here in Istanbul. EuroLeague Women Final 4 semi-final between Avenida and Chopron. 10 minutes left on the clock. Avenida trail by 12 to the Hungarian team Chopron. Elbow jumper from Vujanović, no good. Vujanović misses with that first shot. Avenida need to be near perfect here in the fourth quarter against what has been a very impressive performance by Chopron so far. Gazola to Copper. Copper looking for some space, has to come back out. Rodriguez for three, that one's short. Rebound fight is going to be won by Williams. Fourth rebound of the game. She'll go up the other end and have it swatted away by Alari, and they're going to take possession. And Alari, for me, has been probably the best big in an Avenida roster today. Due to her mobility, able to move and stay with the play a little bit better than some of her teammates have been. Rodriguez kicks it out. Copper, three. And nails the three. Galia Copper. If she turns on the gas, then we're in for a hell of a final quarter. She's up to 16 points now. 6 from 12 from the field. Chopron's lead is down to 9. Last time it's been in single digits for a long while. Williams kicks it out. Brooks doesn't take it. Steps in. Long two. Rattles it home. And Yelena Brooks has been phenomenal today. She's at 25 points personal. Bear in mind, she's only averaging 11 a game this season. Copper. Long two. It's good. 5 quick points for Galia Copper. The defensive end, Avenida need to pick this one up now. Grab a few excessive stops. Williams, long two is no good. Hattar just reaches over, grabs the rebound. Can't hold on to it and throws it out of bounds. Chopron are going to make a change. Williams heads to the bench. They're going to give her a rest, I imagine, bringing her back in for the final maybe 5 minutes. As January returns to the action for Chopron. Zola Going to go baseline. That's where she's been shown. Looks to get the finish, but that one's no good. Good defense and the rebound strong by Jovanovic. Bezvenek now to Brooks. Brooks sees the lane open up, drives inside. The right hand was always going to be a difficult one. Been missing opportunities here in the first few minutes of this fourth quarter. That's off the foot of Brooks. Shot clock will reset back out to 14. Just feel if Avenida score, the next team to score, then I just feel that Coach Gaspar will call a timeout, try and hit the reset button a little bit for his team. Rodriguez to Copper. He's hit their last 5 points. He drives inside, puts up a prayer, no good. The rebound fight is going to come off the hand of Allery, so it'll be a Chopron ball. Tentative times for both of these teams right now. 9-point lead for Chopron. Brooks with possession. Nice and calm at the top. Shot clock down to 10. Jovanovic, nice travels, puts it inside. Hattar can't hold on to it. The pass is a little bit past her. Katie Samuelson will head to the bench. In their place comes her sister, Carly Samuelson. Katie Lou's first EuroLeague women's game since the 1st of Feb. There's a replay of Hattar dropping it out of bounds. Frustration on the Chopron bench. Hopper now. Just find any sort of space to drive inside. Goes in, the shot poor. Foul's going to be called, I think, on Copper. Tries to throw January out of the way for boxing her out. And Coach Gaspar adjusts his collar. I'm sure it's heating up for him. Begvinek now brings it up over the half. 6.5 minutes to play. Chopron by 9. Inside to Hattar, knocked away, and Avenida are defending the threat from the big very well here in the fourth quarter. Samuelson for 3, not this time. Copper, rebound, gets the score. Kalia Copper takes her tally to 20, and as I said, with that score, it's going to push Coach Gaspar into the timeout. What defense from Avenida. Samuelson misses the 3, but Copper is there for the rebound and the score. A 7-point lead now for Chopron. Unbelievable how hard Avenida are having to work. Let's listen to Coach Gaspar, hear what he has to say. Get much bigger than this. 6 minutes and 9 seconds remaining for one of these teams in their EuroLeague women's season. Make or break, 6 minutes ahead of these teams. Going to be some heroes at the end of the day. Potentially some villains as well. Williams now, he's back into the action. Put back to January for 3. No good. Rebound by Copper. And Avenida will have a chance to chip away even more at that lead. 7-2 start to this fourth quarter for Avenida. Rodriguez to drive inside. Has to come back out to Copper. Shot clock at 6. Copper drives in. Doesn't get the score this time. Looks to fight for the rebound. No real surprise. Hattar grabs the rebound, her 7th of the game alongside her 13 points. January back to Hattar, long 2. No good, and the offense has completely dried up for Chopron here. in the fourth quarter. You have a feeling fatigue and pressure are combining to erode their offensive production. Dominguez now comes back. Really want to go up against Hattar at that point. Dead steps back, gets the shot off the glass. What a tough play, Silvio Dominguez. And just like that, Avenida are within 5 points, under 5 minutes to play. Williams picks it out, almost stolen away, but Chopron hold on to it. Shot clock to 9. January, elbow jumper. No good, Hattar wide open. Draws the foul from Carly Samuelson, but it's a smart foul by Samuelson. Been an easy two for Bernadette Hattar. Instead, send it to the free throw line. Going to make her earn her points. Her first trip to the free throw line today. Sorry, her third trip to the free throw line today, Bernadette Hattar. She's 3 from 4 so far. Copper will head to the bench, surprisingly. You see Pazula come back in. I wonder if it's just a grab. Dear Copper, a few breaths. Take her into the final 3 or 4 minutes. Oh, back to back, hits both. Hattar, ice cold. She'll head to the bench now as Dolson comes in. Interesting rotations from both coaches now. Taking out some of their real superstar frontline players with under 4.5 minutes to play. Cazorla goes to the baseline, finds Allery. She'll have to come back out though. Samuelson fakes the three. Up for the mid-range two. That one's no good. Oh, Samuelson struggled today. 6 points, 2 from 5 from the field for her. Williams. Strength to go inside. Comes back out though. Take the long two. That one's short. Foul's going to be called on Jovanovic. First team foul of the quarter for Chopron. 3:58 to go. Chopron with a 7-point lead. This one is hanging in the balance. Coach Gaspar feels the pressure increase as every second passes and as every point Avenida score goes down. Timeout's going to be called by Coach Iniguez, interestingly. We're going to see if we can jump into this Avenida huddle and hear what the coach has to say. Coaches to earn their big pay now. He draws up the play and every possession is going to matter. Bobby Williams heads back onto the floor. 7.6 assists, 5 rebounds for her. Need a trail by 7, under 4 minutes to play. Chopper now shapes up against Williams. Samuelson, not the mismatch, but won't utilize it against Dolson. Dominguez, free throw line jumper, that one's short. Allery almost pushed out of bounds, but they get the rebound. Copper for 3. Oh, that is ice cold. Kalia Copper nails the 3, earning her MVP credentials point by point by point. Unreal play for her. 21 points now. Brooks, 2. No good. Foul's going to be called. Samuelson went down heavy. Dolson went down heavy. Both players still on the floor. Samuelson might have got the worst of that one. Look at the replay. Cazorla called for the foul. Dalton falls onto the leg of Danielson. I think everyone's back on their feet, thankfully. It'll be a shocker on possession on the baseline. Ivanovic will come back to Williams. Got clock to six. Williams won't take the three to Brooks. Brooks fakes the three. Foul's going to be called. I think it's the hip check called on Carly Samuelson. Her third foul. Shouldn't be a worry at this stage of the game, but yeah, it's the right call. Hand onto the hip to stop Brooks from being able to get to the basket. Avenida now in the penalty. January. The Dalton. Shot clock at five. Jovanovic drives inside. Lane opens up. She doesn't get the score though, and the fight's going to go down. Jump ball between Brooks and Samuelson. It will be an Avenida ball on the baseline. That's the way the possession arrow is pointing. That's what coaches talk about when they talk about hustle plays. You see the grit and determination on Samuelson's face. There is no way anyone was taking the ball off her. A four-point lead now for Sopron. Under 3 minutes to play. Can Avenida pull off a huge comeback? They were down by 16 at the half. And now down by just four. Copper looking to shake. Drives inside. Hands it off. Mid-range two. No good. That one's short from Mallory. Sure, Copper should be giving the possession up. To lean on herself. A team need her to step up. Offensive foul, no. Blocking foul, going to be called. Dominguez still moving as the contact was made. Her third foul. That will send Sopron to the free throw line as Hattar comes in. Dalton comes out. I think that's great rotation by Coach Gaspar, as Coach Iniguez takes Allery out, who's been the best defensive player against Hattar, and brings in Hoff, who at times has really struggled to contain the Hungarian big. January, now's the first of her two. Eight points in today's game, January. It's not the points that she brings to the table. It's the control, it's the tempo, it's the leadership that she exhibits on the floor. The Sopron's lead up to six again. Gazzola now turns the corner. Free throw line jumper. Nails it. And Avenida know that they're at the point where they just need every play to go their way. They trail by four. A little over 2 minutes to play. Williams turns the corner. They've got the mismatch. The three. No good. Rebound. Williams. Easy two. Once again, Gabby Williams stepping up when she's needed most. Her sixth rebound of the game. Her 13th point of the game. Sopron's lead out to six again. And Williams has proved time and time again how valuable she is to Sopron. Timeout has been called by Coach Iniguez. One. Under 2 minutes to play, his team trail by six. Let's head into his huddle, hear what he has to say. Iniguez trying to use every single second and some more from that timeout. Clearly trying to create a play. Going to enable them to fight their way back into this one. 1:56 left on the game clock. Sopron lead by six. Avenida have fought hard in this second half. They trailed by 16 at the half because Sopron just put on a masterclass in the first 20 minutes. Zorla advances it up over the half. Big possession here for Avenida. They're all going to be big from now on. Hoff, corner, Cazorla, three, no good. Rebound is out for grabs. Copper grabs the rebound, draws the foul. Hits the hardwood with some force. Only the second team foul of the quarter for Sopron, though. So it'll be a sideline possession. That's smart play, managing their fouls. Begvanek going to be called for the foul. Copper will have to pick herself up off the floor. And they'll have to go again. 1 minute 40 left on the clock now. Feel the nervous tension amongst the players, that's for sure. Sopron on the verge of a big win. Avenida close potentially to the end game, their end chance of making it to the final, claiming the title. Minguez to Copper. Copper now looking to shake. Hattar drives inside. Great defense by Hattar, led her down a cul-de-sac. And Copper had nowhere to go. Sopron almost lost possession, but they're going to recover it. Their shot clock is down to 12. Williams now waits for the screen from Hattar. Pulls up, elbow three, no good. Rebound by Hattar, one-handed, what a big play. They're going to run out the shot clock again. January, if Sopron get a score, January for three. No, doesn't get it to go. It's still alive for Avenida. Dominguez now comes back out. Hoff doesn't take the jumper, drives inside. Foul's going to be called, I think, on Hattar as she hobbles away. Begvanek's going to get called for the blocking foul. Yeah, look how wide her legs are. Right, cool. Off will head for the line for free throws. Timeout's been called, though, by Coach Gaspar. Wants to ice the shooter. Apply a little bit more pressure onto Hoff. Make her think about her free throws. Hopefully ice her out of the game. Hoff is only a 67% free throw shooter prior to tonight's game. 2 from 2 so far, though. Let's head into the huddle, hear what Coach Gaspar has to say. Part of the game now for Sopron is nerve and patience. Time management is key as we see some signs of the Sopron faithful here in Istanbul. I'm sure they'll be happy to come back on Sunday and see their team play in the final if Sopron can close out the final 48 seconds of this game. Hoff will head to the free throw line now. Just 6 points for Hoff so far today. She's the first of her two, and that hurts. Good pull by Coach Gaspar. Icing the free throw shooter by calling that timeout. Misses the second as well. She goes for her own rebound. Doesn't get it. 6 point lead now for Sopron. 40 seconds to play. Avenida certainly don't want to foul. They do need to put some pressure on them. They certainly can't let Sopron score. Williams can only throw it away, but it'll be out of bounds. 4 seconds remaining now on the shot clock. 26 seconds on the game clock. Still plenty of time for Avenida to work with. Katie Lou Samuelson will come in for her sister, Carly Samuelson, for Avenida. Oh, backdoor pass, gets the score, and none other than Brooks is there to score it. Who else would it be? 27 points for Yelena Brooks. Katie Lou for three. Samuelson can't get it. Cazorla has to kick it out. Another three from Katie Lou. Samuelson nails this one. 12 seconds left. Timeout called by Coach Gaspar. Is it a little too late for Avenida? They trail by five. 12 seconds to play for Avenida as we see a replay of Samuelson. What this entire play will be drawn up to do. For Avenida, give it a second try and steal it clean. If you can't, you have to foul straight away. Can they get it in? They can to Hattar. They need to foul. No foul called. They're going to drop it out of bounds. 9 seconds left. 5 points difference. As Chopron turn it over. Unbelievable. They just needed to get it inbounds and hold on to it, really. But Hattar looks to throw it back to Jovanovic, and Jovanovic spills it out of bounds. The game is still alive here in Istanbul. 9 seconds to play. Coach Iniguez with a timeout. Let's listen to what he is going to draw up. And the play is drawn up. 9 seconds to play. 5 point lead for Chopron. What a game we have had here so far. Unbelievable drama all the way to the final buzzer. Can Avenida do the impossible and fight their way back from 16 down at the half? Dominguez inbounds it to Samuelson. Samuelson from the logo. Off target, Copper grabs the rebound, but it's going to be pulled away. This is going to be a Chopron win. What a game for the Hungarian team. The celebrations are ignited on the floor as the coaches shake hands. What a game. Chopron have earned their place at the EuroLeague Women Final on Sunday, and much deserved. What a game. A first half of dominant performance from Chopron. A tough fight back from Avenida, but it wasn't enough, as they will be in the third place playoff. Emotions are high. The fans are loving it that have made the trip from Chopron in Hungary here to Istanbul. And that player there has a huge amount to take credit for. Yelena Brooks ends up with 27 points and 4 rebounds. She has done it all for her team here today. And they learn their fate on Sunday. Can they win the title? Celebrations, rightfully so, in the middle of the floor here in Istanbul. What a game. They have dealt us a wonderful game as the coaching staff congratulate one another. and a wonderfully coached game from Coach Gaspar as well. And Chopron upset the form book. Final score here in the semi-final is Avenida 69, Chopron 74. It's Chopron who head to the final on Sunday. A phenomenal game from Chopron, absolutely amazing. 1 through 12 absolutely did their job here today. The first half was where the game was made. They led by 16 at the halfway stage. They looked absolutely dominant in that first half as they celebrate with their fans in the crowd. You can see them bouncing on the floor. They've had a wonderful game and they've earned, absolutely earned every last bit of praise they're getting, and they've earned their ticket through to the final on Sunday. The Chopron leading scorer, Yelena Brooks, 27 points and 4 rebounds alongside 2 steals. Hattar, 15 points, 10 rebounds for her. She's got a double-double. Gabby Williams, the other player in double digits, 13 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists. But an all-round strong team performance from Chopron. And they will wait to see who they face in the final. The second semi-final coming up shortly on this floor as Praha take on Fenerbahce. But what a game the first semi-final has been. Told you to strap yourself in for a big 40 minutes of basketball. Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. What a performance. Here's some of the highlights from that first half of action. What a game we've had here in Istanbul in the first semi-final. It really has been unbelievably impressive. And for Avenida, absolute heartbreak. They were runners-up last season. They're going to go into the third-place match on Sunday for this season. Leah Copper did what she could. She had 23 points, 6 rebounds. No other player in double digits, though, as Avenida's offense was strangled by a very impressive defensive performance by Chopron. A wonderful game here and a real advert for the highest level of women's basketball. Superstars on show. And did they put on a show for us? They absolutely did. A wonderful first semi-final, and we can just hope that the second semi-final lives up to that level. But did what she could throughout the game. She really did try her hardest, but it wasn't enough as Chopron across the board had big games. January there with the long two, did what she needed to do. Backdoor pass there inside to Velaro. See much of the action here today. And you have to say, Coach Gaspar won the coaching battle as well. Rotational strategy, the way he brought in and out players, worked to perfection. In particular, Bernadette Hattar worked it so the player she was facing, who she was going up against, struggled against her. She was fresh, didn't get in serious foul trouble too long. Same can be said for Gabby Williams as well. So a hat tip to that man there, but so much credit to the players, particularly Brooks. What a performance. You have to bear in mind, she's averaging just over 11 points a game and she's dropped 27 in today's game. She really has to be credited with one of the main reasons that Chopron will be in the final on Sunday. As for Avenida, heartbreak for them. Runners-up last year. The best they can hope for this year is a third-place finish. And that will come down to the game on Sunday against the loser from the other semi-final, which will take place shortly on this floor, either Praha or Fenerbahce. What a wonderful game. So many highlights for us to look through as well. This is a game that you can re-watch time and time again. Wonderful performance by Chopron in the first half, chalking up 47 points. However, Avenida really locked them down in the second half. They limited Chopron to just 27 points in the second half, but it wasn't enough as Chopron make it through to the final. The final score here in Istanbul is Avenida 69, Chopron 74. What a game. Semi-final one is in the books. Chopron make it through to the final. Semi-final two will be starting shortly. Make sure you join me for all the action in that one here in Istanbul.